Hi, I'm Chris Heiser from Internet 2 and University of Pennsylvania, and this is Grouper Training, Admin Track, Web Services, Part 1. We'll have an introduction, talk about downloading the web services, installing them, upgrading them, authentication from clients, WS Star security, and app servers. So web services are part of Grouper that use the Grouper API to interact with the Grouper registry. And clients and built-in components and connectors talk to web services to have a secure channel to Grouper. You can download the web services from Grouper's software page. You can download them via the Grouper installer, and then you can unzip them, and there's four directories: Grouper WS, Grouper WS, Java Generated Client, Manual Client, and Grouper Test, WS Test. The Grouper WS one is probably the only folder that you need to be concerned about, unless you're going to try to run the tests. So to install it, the Grouper installer can do this for you, or you can do it manually with Java 6, Ant, and a servlet container. So the first thing you do is edit grouper-ws/build.properties and set the Grouper directory to be wherever Grouper is. So in this case, I set this line of the properties file. And then you can run ant dist from the command line. This will run and compile things if it needs to, copy properties files, and build the WAR file. Based on the build.properties, it can do other things for you as well, but normally this is all you need to do. And at the very end, it'll say build successful. If you're upgrading an existing web services install, generally what you do is download the new version, merge any configurations changes that you made from the old version to the new version, and point to your updated copy of the Grouper API, whatever you're upgrading to, and then build and deploy that. So you should keep track of any configuration changes that you make as you deploy the web services. For authentication, Grouper WS ships with servlet container authentication, and you can configure your user and password in the Tomcat users XML. For example, if you're using Tomcat, that's what the file is. If you need other authentication, you can disable the servlet container authentication by editing the web XML. You remove the security constraint, login config, security role sections, and build again. So if I'm looking at the web XML, just find the first security constraint section and login config security role and just remove all that, save, and then you can build again. If you have a web server in front of your app server, you could use that authentication as long as remote user is passed through or you write a connector to grab whatever the username is. There are other authentications built in. There's a Kerberos user pass configuration where you can edit the Grouper WS.properties, and then you would pass the Kerberos username and password and HTTP basic auth, and you also need to set the Kerberos KDC. So if you're looking at your Grouper WS, you can go down to the authentication section and you could put the Kerberos one in there. You can extend subclass or an interface, implement this interface, and then you can have whatever authentication you want. If it's remote user, then Grouper will do that for you automatically. For WS Star Security with SOAP, you need to set this in the build.properties, the use rampart equals true, then build again, and then in the build, in the services directory under webinf, you'll see that the normal AARs, say on deck, and the WSSEC AARs are ready to be used. And note that you can't run WS Star and non-WS Star SOAP in the same WAR file. You can deploy both into separate JVMs if you want. So here you see what the WebInf services directory looks like when you're not doing WS Security. All the WS Security AARs have on deck as an extension, which means they won't be used, and all the regular ones don't have that. And when you have WS Security, you'll see the regular ones have OnDeck, and the WSSEC ones do not have an OnDeck. The OnDeck ones are still there, but as long as there's an AAR file that doesn't say OnDeck, then you're good. Generally, Grouper Web Services run in the Servlet 2.5 container, and people use Tomcat 6 mostly, but you could use anything. So you can deploy your WAR file however you want to. One way is to take the WAR file and put it in the servlet container. So in Tomcat, you would drop that in the web apps directory. And then once you have deployed it, you can test it using the Grouper client, and you can see the Grouper client training for details on that. Or you can hit the status servlet. If you're on localhost on port 8090, then you can hit status ? Diagnostic type equals sources. And it'll try to hit all the databases and the sources, allocate some memory, and just make sure that everything is working. You could also hit a REST HTTP param service with a browser. In this case, I'm going to see what the members are of the Etsy sysadmin group by going to this URL. And this part depends on what version you're running. If it's 2.1.0, then that's what you would do. And note that you have to URL encode the group name. So for instance, a colon is %3A. And when you do that with the XML format, that's the result that you get. Click on the quiz in the description part of the video to test your knowledge on this topic. For further information, here are some links. And thank you very much.